we played the cat scratch game. So how it works is you tell a scary story about a cat. My friend with the blue shirt is saying the story. My other friend is laying down while she rubs her temple. When she got up, there was 3 scratches on her back, and we checked her back before. It was completely clear. I don't know. This is kind of scary. Don't try it at home. You might get demons in your house.
Cursed games you should never play, part 10. One man hide and seek. For this game you will need a stuffed doll, and you should give it a name. First you cut it open and remove the stuffing, and replace it with rice and fingernail clippings, then sew it back up. Then put the toy in the bath and say, for the first game, I'm it. Count to 10 with your eyes closed, stab the toy and say I won. And say, for this game, you are it. Now go hide with some salt water with you. If an hour has passed, then you won the game. Go find the toy, spit the salt water on it and burn it. Where would you hide? Cursed games you should never play, part 6. This one is called Dry Bones. To play the game you should begin at exactly 12:01 a.m. Get a candle and a match and go to your bathroom. This game has a prize if you win, so think about any prize you want. Light up the candle and stare at the mirror and wait until the match burns out completely. When it does, say I am aware of your presence and I welcome you into my home. Come now. So now you just invited a demon into your house. If you hear a groaning sound, then he is here. Now you should hide until 3 a.m. If you survived until 3 a.m. then say, thank you for playing, but you must leave now, you are no longer welcome. You will hear a groan again and he will leave. And the next morning you will have your prize in the front door. Cursed games you should never play, part 5. This one is the elevator game. So to play this game you should find a building with 10 floors and an elevator. Start at the first floor and enter the elevator. And go to floors 4, 2, 6, 2, 10 and 5. All at this exact order without anyone entering the elevator. If a woman enters the elevator at the 5th floor, do not look at her, do not talk to her and don't speak at all. This woman is not a human and if you do any of this, she will keep you forever. After that press the first floor and this should take you to the 10th floor. Leave the elevator and if she asks where you're going, don't respond. Now if you see this red cross on windows, then you are in another world. You are alone there and the electronics don't work. To go back, simply do the same thing all over again. Would you play the game?
If you and your friends are the type of people that love to get scared and do something on the edge, but can't ever find anything to do when you are hanging out, this video is exactly for you. Yo, what's up? These are scary things you can do with your friends. Part 1. First one's gonna be hostage and the rules are super simple. The players will meet at a central location and split up into 2 teams consisting of a driver, a navigator, and 2 hostages. The driver and the navigator will take the hostages of the opposing team and they'll drop them off at an undisclosed location. No phones, no nothing, just them in the dark. It's pretty insane. Next, you're gonna be getting your friends together at 3 in the morning, going into the woods, and playing a board game in the middle of the woods. And the reason I say 3 in the morning is because it's considered the devil's hour, meaning something demonic or supernatural could happen. And if you're into that, well, you just might wanna play this game. Last one's gonna be Randonautica, and I'm sure you've heard of it, but basically it sends you to a random location with you having an intent of what you wanna see, and there's different settings to it. Anomaly's the scary one, but basically these kids got sent to a random location and there was a dead body in a suitcase, so if you wanna possibly see a dead body, then play Randonautica. Not saying it will send you to one, but just saying.
Part 1 of Baby Blue, a scary horror game that you can play by yourself, at home, at your own risk. So to play Baby Blue, you go to a bathroom by yourself. When it's dark, make sure that the lights are off, and you stand in front of the mirror. And you hold your arms like you're cradling a baby. And you start cradling your arms back and forth, back and forth. And that's when you start repeating, baby blue, blue baby. Baby blue, blue baby. And repeat this 13 times. And you will slowly begin to feel the weight of a baby in your arms growing larger and larger. And eventually, once the baby gets large enough, as everybody who's ever held a newborn knows, baby nails are very sharp, you will start to feel a baby clawing or scratching your arm.
games to try with your friends. So everybody remembers, like in elementary, when they used to play Charlie. Well, I found a game similar to it with a girl named Martha. So this game originated in El Salvador, and it was really popular in the early 2000s. So what you do is, instead of a paper like Charlie, you have three pens, and with the pens, you make a triangle with them. So after you have the pens up, you say, Martita, ¿quieres jugar conmigo? Or, Martha, will you play with me? You say that three times. And if she feels like playing, the pens will move, and if not, you can try again later. So if it ends up working and the game officially starts, you can ask her any question you want. It just has to be a yes and no. If the answer is yes, the pens will stay closed, still forming the triangle, and if it's no, they will move. I couldn't find any exact rule to how to, like, end it. Like, you know how, like, in Charlie, you kind of just stop playing? But people have said that they have felt, like, presence around them after, so... Maybe just, like, sage your house or something, or, like, say prayers, I don't know. But yeah, that's it. Play at your own risk.
What's up, guys? Today we are going to be talking about the game Red Door, Yellow Door, a paranormal game that allows you to enter your own mind and to do some exploring. And that is why this game is also called Doors to the Mind. For this game, you are going to need two people, although you are more than welcome to have more there as witnesses. One person is going to be the guide, the other is going to be the subject. To play this game, the guide needs to sit crisscross applesauce on the floor with a pillow in their lap, whereas the subject will lay with their head on the pillow, which is on the guide's lap, and they are going to place their hands in the air like so. And that is when the guide is going to start a little chant called Red Door, Yellow Door, Any Other Color Door. And at this time, any witnesses need to